Welcome back, everyone, to Part 2 of Lesson 6, Level 2. Now that we've completed our amortization table, and we know how much of each of our quarterly payments goes to interest and to principal, we can return to our cash flow sheet and now fill in the interest expense here in row 14. To calculate the interest expense for these cells, we're going to have to use a formula called CUMIPMT, or Cumulative Interest Payments. As the name implies, this formula will allow us to find out how much interest will be paid between two points in time. So we need to figure out how much interest was paid during year 1, year 2, year 3, year 4, and year 5. So we'll come back over here, and so for year 1 we have those four periods. Let's go over here and find our starting period and our ending period, 1 and 4. So let's start our cumulative interest payment formula. The rate is 8% divided by 4 periods per year. Number of periods is the loan duration in years, 5 times 4. Our present value is $1 million. Now our starting period for year 1 is going to be 1, and our ending period is going to be 4. Oops, forgot my 0. End of period. Hit enter, and that gives us about $75,000. Let me go in and put absolute references on all these cells so I can copy them down here in a minute. Now I've got that for the first year. Let me copy it down, and then I'll just go in and say, okay, for the next year, that's going to be quarters 5 through 8. The next one, 9 through 13. Oops, 9 through 12, actually. An easier way to handle it might be to come over here and start putting here a 1 and then a 4. And then for year 2, I got a 5 and an 8. And now that I've got a little pattern here for 1 and 5, if I just drag that down, autofill will automatically complete that sequence, knowing that there's 4 between each of those. And the same for this one. Pretty cool, huh? Now, instead of that 1 and the 4, I don't like numbers hard-coded there in the cells, so let me get the actual cells in there in place of these. And now we're a little better off than we were a minute ago. Looks like our overall interest is the same. So that's a good sign. But I need to come up with some formulas that automatically come up with a 1 and a 4 based on year 1. Or for year 2, automatically come up with a 5 and 8, 3, 9 through 12, etc. So let's come up with some formulas here. I'm going to do the end formula first because it looks like it's pretty simple math. 1 turns into 4, 2 turns into 8. 3 turns into 12. So I can see that if I multiply the year by the number of periods per year, or 4, we'll be in good shape. So I'm going to multiply it by that number there and make it absolute referenced. Hit enter. And now if I drag it down, cool. Now if I take that formula and paste it in here, instead of that H11, I put that formula in there. Then if I drag it down, do I still have the same numbers? Yes, so we're good. Now let's come up with the tricky one. I need to convert 1 into 1, 2 into 5, 3 into 9, 4 into 13, 5 into 17. So what do we do there? Using a little mathematical wizardry, I see that if I take that year and multiply it by the number of periods per year, and then subtract out 3, why 3? Because it's 1 less than the number of periods per year, I get the right numbers for all those cells. So now, I can do the 3 there. But again, you know me and hard-coded numbers, I want it to work for all different combinations of years and periods per years and loan durations, etc. So instead of that 3, I really want to take, put it in parentheses, and I want to take that cell that contains the number of periods per year and subtract 1 for it, and it'll give us a 3 for a quarterly payment. Let me copy that down. Oops, forgot to put absolute references on that B5. Fix that, copy it down. Now we're good. Now let me copy that formula, copy, escape, come over here and replace that G11, paste it in there, and I should be good to go. Let me copy that formula down. Awesome, still got the same numbers. Everything's working. Just as a quick check, let me see if I can delete those columns and my numbers are still there. So my formulas are coherent and work. Now let's do the same thing over here. Let's see how good I am at creating this from scratch. So for the rate, take that 8% absolute reference, divide it by the number of periods per year, absolute reference. Multiply the number of periods by the number of years. Now the present value, absolute reference on that by F4, starting period. Now, what I need the year number, which is 1, that cell right there, multiply it by the number of periods per year, and then I'm going to subtract out, let me put the absolute reference in there, subtract out, parentheses, the number of periods per year minus 1, close that parentheses, hit a comma. Now the end period, that was the easier one. That was just the year number times the number of payments per year. Absolute reference, comma, 0. Close the parentheses. Let's see how good I did. All right, that looks good. Can I copy it across? Looks right. Let me copy it onto this sheet and paste it into the other one to compare. And I want the cells right next to each other, so I remember that if I have a paste special and I do values and then transpose it, it'll flip it from horizontal to vertical. And all the numbers look good. Let me copy this formula to the right. Oops, too wide. Numbers match. Formula works. Awesome. So now I have the interest expense for the entire year. See you in the next video.